We're going into the Access Centre here in Ballymun. Brian Kerr, the Irish Landry, Ireland International Manager, is being launching a Parents Network project in here today, and I'm going to try and get an exclusive interview with the man. Taking out my famous camera here, my famous little camera. As soon as I get a shot of him, a good shot, I'm going to go for it. Has the man arrived yet, has he?
Neil, can I have your name,
sir? Yeah, Seamus Kelly Ballymun, come on. Seamus Kelly Ballymun Concrete News. Right, Mark?
Yeah.
Oh, there he is, that's Brian. Yeah. Declan, Brian, can I have a shot? Is that okay if we have a shot? Shoot your photographs, did you?
Is that what?
Shoot your photographs, did you?
No.
Did you not take any time?
No. He's only had to walk in it.
No.
This is actually Seamus Kelly, and he works in the local paper for the Concrete News.
Is that your sister?
So the other thing really is that this is your shame.
This time, just one shot with just.
Yeah, you go ahead, Brian. Yeah, yeah. I have to wipe my hands in case he shakes my hand again or whatever. It's possible we might get to shake hands again, so I've got to make sure my hands are not. I've got to make sure my hands are not sweaty in case we shake hands again. Human touch.
We'll have to tell teacher where you were today, won't we? You want to tell teacher?
Brian, Seamus Kelly Ballymun Concrete News. Nice to see you again. I don't know, covered in the super value. Brett, can we have a few minutes here? Hi.
Seamus, there you are.
Nice
that was
you.
A great paper you done last week.
Oh,
I enjoyed it.
Thanks very much, Roy.
Agreed.
Right, you too. Bye. I found the Ballymun Concrete News because up to that point in time, Ballymun had received massive negative publicity for over a 38-year span. And I thought, you know, we need to address this. And I remember at the time ringing up all the news editors that I was doing kind of business with in the nationals, in the media, that I was going to be submitting positive copy from now on to turn things around in Ballymun. Having said, I have been challenged by some NUJ officials that I should be covering negative news. And I said, there's no way you can take me to court if you like. The mission statement is the Ballymun Concrete News is to publish, you know, positive news. And I actually did cover a murder in the area many, many years ago. It was a horrific murder. And I said, I've got to do this, but I've got to do it in a positive way. And the positive approach was that the Gardaí caught these people within a matter of days, and that was the approach that I used. But exclusive. Well, you know, we always have an exclusive on the front page, Jamie. It's my fault, basically. I should have typed that and sent it up to you. Gotta get this guy. There we go. Straight away, he was in the toilet. It just might look. No. Hang on a second. Today, the same winds of change are blowing, right? Right down as far as and their community's well-being, right?
Yeah.
And then you come down forward and delete all that paragraph there.
What paragraph?
I don't have any capital. I've used all my own personal monies to keep this newspaper alive and the support of the local community to the businesses, advertising and stuff like that. Overdrafts from the bank, loans from the bank, loans from the credit union, and that's the only way I can keep this newspaper alive. I'm trusting you on this one, Jamie.
Yeah.
Go for it. You've borne that disc now.
Okay, will do.
And well done, you've done a great job, Jamie, okay?
Okay,
well done. See you, bye.
See
you. Bye. I'm sorry. That's it. Magic. Well, this is the current issue that was brought out in February, and it's about the Ballymun Tower block about to be blasted 3-2-1 boom. And that's just a photograph of the Sean McDermott Tower. The Brian Kerr interview, yeah, that was interesting. Yeah, that's me there with the dictaphone. Not too near, not too far. I'm just trying, I'm trying to coax him up a little bit with the dictaphone, hoping he'll lift his head and look directly at me, you know.
Where can I get that in
future? You know, you know the Civic Centre down the road, or you can pick it up the Sparrow in Ballymun. You can pick it up the library down the road. You know the library?
Yeah.
This building has been up since 1968 now, so it's been up there for a long time, and I'm sure there's a lot of families who used to live in that tower who brought their children and grandchildren up there. They're probably around somewhere this morning. Two, one. Wait for it. Good job, good job. Wow. One more last one. I can't believe I'm actually doing this, you know, after being stuck indoors for nearly 8 years. I couldn't go outside the bloody door, end of story, you know, because I had this agoraphobia condition and claustrophobia. Couldn't work, couldn't go to the shops. My wife had to look after me most of the time, and my kids couldn't understand what was wrong with me. I couldn't understand what was wrong with me. Even going to the doctor was a problem, you know, about 200 or 300 metres across the road to go to the doctor was a problem. And I literally, when I met people on the street, you know, when I did have to go out, I literally have to, I got a panic attack and have to run home. Didn't understand it. Used to cry myself to sleep at night praying that it'd go away.
Went into his own little warden, his own little thing, and it was very difficult. It was difficult because people thought that I wasn't married, or that he was dead, or something, because they hadn't seen us out together for years, you know. Maybe they thought I had them under the floorboard. I don't know, but I know for a fact they didn't even, you know, connect. And for a long time, even after the breakdown, they didn't connect us because we were never together, like.
I can't pinpoint one specific or blame one specific thing, but I know it happened at a time when Kay and I were involved with the Charismatic Renewal. And I think, you know, in relation to Charismatic Renewal at the time, in the 70s or whatever, you know, it's a highly emotive experience, and I don't think in this country we're kind of made for that kind of a mode of deep expression and getting into yourself so much and being over emotional as it were. Jamie!
Hiya.
Jamie, come on! There's my father. Look at your hair. You look great.
Hey,
you look terrific. You look terrific. That's Sharon, my daughter. I got two cards. It's going to be a check, and this is my daughter. I want a big
that's
check.
My card, Daddy.
Oh, this is Jamie. Excuse me. Excuse me. It's Jamie Waters' card. Jamie Waters. Jamie Waters.
You simply like socks, yeah? I love those.
What is this? Kay always cuts me hair because I hate going to the barber.
I've never seen this ever.
Put that in the group and you won't get another one for years.
Happy birthday, dear granddad. Happy birthday to you.
Hip, hip, hooray.
Hip, hip, hooray.
Hip, hip, hooray. Have to blow out the candles now, don't we?
Make a wish.